Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another JVS movie review brought to you by the Fantastic Fest. I think you've already seen Jorge and Sam drop reviews from the Fantastic Fest, so this is my first review from this festival, and this one is another Netflix horror movie that I think is scheduled to drop October 6th. This one is called There's Someone Inside Your House, and here's the synopsis. The graduating class at Osmoor High is being targeted by a mass assailant, intent on exposing the darkest secrets of each victim, and only a group of misfit outsiders can stop the killings. This is directed by Patrick Bryce. It stars Sydney Park, Theodore Pellerin, and Ashai Cooper. I think I'm saying her name right. I hope I'm saying her name right. She's in All American too. So she's known to the Netflix audience, I think, from All American more than anything else. So here's the thing about this film. Netflix, a couple of months ago, with Fear Street 94, brought back the 90s type feel of horror movie. And here, they attempt to give you it again, the slasher element of it. So with Fear Street 94, what we saw was a great interpretation on what a 90s horror movie was. What you got out the screams, to a lesser extent than I Know What You Did Last Summers. But here, with There's Someone in the House, this is like, unfortunately, even though it wants to be a 90s horror movie, it's closer to a 2000s horror movie. So it's very reminiscent of House of Wax or Darkness Falls. Like when we are introduced to, in this film, we're introduced to a character who is supposed to be a football player who falls asleep. I'm not giving too much of a movie away here by telling you that he falls asleep. And then he wakes up to be hunted by a killer who exposes the secrets of some actions that he took. And the moment we get that and we get kind of the way the movie's going to progress, the movie gets bad. This unfortunately is not a good horror movie. This is every bad element of a 90s to 2000 horror movie slasher film that came out. This had every bad element of it in it, down to the teens in this film not particularly being likable. And not likable in a sense where they go out their way and that they are just bad teenagers. Not that type of likable. I mean, in the sense that you just don't particularly care about this group of misfit friends. While we see that they're outsiders, which is another trope of 90s and 2000 horror movies, we see that there are outsiders, a ragtag group who gets together to combat evil or whatever they're trying to do here. None of it comes across as believable. You don't even believe that these group of people would ever be friends. It makes no sense. This, unfortunately, this is a huge step back for Netflix in their horror genre. This is based off of a YA novel. So, another horror movie based off of a YA novel, just like Fear Street. But where everywhere that Fear Street progressed and succeeded at, this movie fails at. Down to the two leads in these two films. Fear Street lead was amazing. And here we have Miss Sydney Park, who, while she does a valiant effort, she's just, nothing here works for her. In the end, nothing works for most of the characters in here, and this just falls into the trap of a whodunit slasher film with an ending that is supposed to be a surprise. But if you know anything about horror movies, you kind of picked up on this ending 20 to 30 minutes into this film. So unfortunately, you get to sit through and watch this film drag itself out like this is going to be a surprise when you get to the ending. And when you finally get there, you're like, oh, I kind of figured that out from the beginning of this film. That's part of the issues with this film here. I'll also say, unfortunately, it's not the best looking Netflix horror movie. From Fear Street to The Old Ways to a multitude of other Netflix horror films, whether they be the B-type horror movies or maybe more well-known-ish horror films. all of them look better than this one. This one just, it took on everything bad with a horror movie. And then you kind of wonder, like, what was the goal of this? And I'm still confused here. I'm still confused here. And this was something that I was dying to see at the Fantastic Fest. This is a movie that I was like, okay, I really want to see this movie. When I found out it was a Netflix movie, that made me even more hype because of them coming off of Fear Street and The Old Ways. I'm like, you're coming off of a great horror trilogy and in The Old Ways, possibly the best horror movie this year. How are you going to succeed yourself with There's Someone in a House? And as generic as the name sounds, it's about as generic as this movie is. So, There's Someone in the House, brought to you again at the Fantastic Fest, which will be dropping on Netflix on October the 6th. Out of a possible 10, I'm going to give this movie a 4.5 out of 10. This, again, it's if you like cheesy slasher films, by all means, tune into it. I think you'll like it. If any part of you are expecting a good movie or even a semi-good movie, how about even an average movie? Skip it. This movie will not be for you, and you will leave disappointed, unfortunately. But this has been another JVS Movie Review. Peace, people.